Hi, I'm Matt Degen with the Orange County Register, and today we are getting an exclusive preview of Halo 3, which hits stores Tuesday, September 25th. We have an early copy, and we're going to check it out a little bit and kind of see what all the big hoopla is about of why this game is going to be such a big one. Here we are. This is one of the beginning missions, and one of the really great marks of a game is when you can see water images such as this, and you can see the reflections, and that is really hard to recreate when you're doing graphics. So that just shows the power of this console and what the developers at Bungie have done to create a really shining game. And here we are, we're in a jungle area on Earth, and this is the year about 2556, and we are making our way towards some enemy ambushes that are going to come about here. And of course, I'm playing as Master Chief. That is the futuristic super soldier. He's kind of like half human, half robot. Let's say he's just enhanced. The lighting environments, I think gamers are really going to really enjoy seeing this compared to Halo 2. Looks great. And again, we're just making our way over some really nice terrain. And if you look at the attention to detail on the leaves and on the lighting, it's really impressive. Sergeant Major, Phantom inbound. And we have some enemies approaching here on top. They're going to be dropping in. And here we're coming to a clearing. And you can see a bad guy right there. And they're going to be everywhere. Of course, along with our nice guns, we have some grenades that we can throw. A lot of ways to get these guys. And here we have some nasty arrivals, and they'll be jumping off the ship here. I think what gamers and fans of the series are really going to enjoy is that it's so smooth. There's not a whole lot of lagging on load times. And that just means that you really don't have to wait a whole lot to play the game. You can get right into it, and as the game progresses, you're not going to be waiting a whole lot for kind of the system to load and everything. That can be a real drag when you're kind of in the heat of battle. And like I say, I'm about 4 hours into this game, and I haven't had really any issues with load times. So, you know, we got to give applause to Bungie for creating a really nice flow of action. As far as gripes for Halo 3, not a whole lot. Probably the biggest complaint you're going to hear that I've noticed also, as well as other reviewers, is that the artificial intelligence of the enemies is a little bit lacking at points. This is especially apparent when they're driving a vehicle. Unfortunately, they really can't drive. They're like a 16-year-old behind the wheel there. So if you want to survive in some of those fights, you're probably going to want to take the wheel yourself. I think it's going to be everything that we've been hoping for. If you're a Halo fan, you're really definitely not going to be disappointed in this game. Bungie's delivered a really great game in Halo 3. I think it's everything we expected. And it's going to be exciting in the future to see how online this plays out, where we have a lot of customization. And I think this is going to be carried on for a good number of years to come.